students, sixth English medium. We are pursuing the biology with chapter number 8, that body movements. Now, in this chapter, we almost learn about first the different joints in our body, and that how the joints allow which type of motion, like ball and socket joint allowing the all direction, then hinge joint only in one direction, then pivotal joint in so many planes, etc. And we also learn about the fixed joints which do not allow any movement at all. Then skeleton, in the skeleton the rib cage, the other bones, the backbone, pelvic bones, shoulder bones, and the structure of them. And finally, in our human body, we learned that how the muscle and the bones together make possible the different movements. Then we learn about some other animals also that do not have any type of skeleton. Then how do they move? We already learned about the animals like a snail, an earthworm, then a cockroach, and the birds. Today we are going to learn about the movement of the fish. We know that fish live in water, and therefore its body must be have a special shape such that it can swim in the water. Now, when you make a paper boat and put it in the water, then you see that when we make that boat, the narrow part of the front is put in the direction of the water. Then the boat can easily swim in the direction of the water. But if you put it other way, then it is not easy to move for that boat. Why? Because when the pointed part is water side, then what happens? The water will move sideways, and it allows the easy movement of the boat. But if you put the broad side toward the water, then it is quite difficult to move for that boat. So now you can compare the body of the fish and shape of the boat. You will see some similarity. The fish also have, like in the front, the body is narrow by the mouth. In the middle, it's broad. And when going back toward the tail, again is getting narrow. And this special shape allow the easy movement for fish in the water. And this special type of shape is known as streamlined. Means its body is streamlined body. So you can say that here the streamlined shape. What is the streamlined shape? That narrow from the front, then broad in the middle, and then back, narrow at the back side towards the tail. So that type of the streamlined shape is allowing the fish to move easily in the water. Also, the skeleton of the fish is covered with strong muscles, and due to that, what happens? Such that the front part of the body curves to one side and the tail part swings to the opposite sides. Maybe you have watched some fish when they are moving. They don't move like straight. They make waves like that when they. Why? Because the body is made like that. It make a one curve, and in the front it make a curve, and then opposite side, the tail side swing in the opposite direction, and then it makes a jerk to the body, and due to that jerk, the body moves to the front side. So here you can see that the skeleton of fish is covered with strong muscles such that the front part of the body curves to one side and the tail part swings to the opposite side, and the fish forms a curve while swimming by this way. It makes a jerk and pushes the body forward. As you can see the picture here, so you can see that body part is curved this side and the tail on the opposite direction, and by this movement it allows the body to swim because it get a jerk, and because of the jerk the body is pushed forward. So by this way the fish are moving in the direction. Now in this motion the fins that are on the body of the side that allows the help in the motion. So when it is swimming the fins also helping in the movement. There are some other more fins are also on the body of the fish, and that other fins that are helping to keep the balance of the body while swimming, and also it keep the direction, means direction in which it's going, keep that perfect particular direction also. Maybe you have seen the divers that move in the water. They wear some special thing in the feet which moves like that tail of the fish and fins, so that it allows them to swim properly in the water. So that is the way the fish move in the water. At the last, we are going to learn about how the snake move. Now the snake, you know that snake moves by slithering on the soil, on the land. It never goes straight. It cannot go, it cannot move straight, but it's slithering in the curves. Now the body of the snake have a long backbone, very long backbone, and muscles, so many muscles which are very very thin muscles. Now all these muscles are connected to each other, but though they are not so close to each other, but they are enough far to each other also. So they are connected to each other even though they are far from one another. I mean they are connected, but not very very closely. They are far enough because to make a curvy movement, because they are not moving straight. Therefore, the muscles will have space between them, though they are interconnected also. And muscles interconnect the backbone, ribs and skin also. So the skin, the ribs, backbone, everything are also interconnected with the special thin muscles in the body of the snake. Now, the body, if you have seen the snake, you will see that when it moves, it goes in so many loops. And what is that for that things? Each loop of the snake gives it a forward push by pressing against the ground. What does it do? The snake makes so many loops, and that each loops give it push forward because they are pressing against the soil, against the land, against the ground. And now each loop will give the push forward. Then one by one, all the loops will give a forward push to the body of the fish. And therefore, by this so many loops, it can move very, very far, very, very fast, quickly, but not in a straight line. Because of that curvy loops, it cannot go straight, but due to the each loop, as I told you, they are getting a push forward because they give the pressure against the ground, and then it is getting pushed forward. And thus, by those, you can see the picture also of the snake here. How does it move? By making the loops and so on. So when it is moving also, if you have seen, it go very fast by this making loops and not in a straight line. So now in this chapter, we learn about some other animals also. There are so many animals, other animals also. Then we can see that the bones and muscles are for the movements. But there are other questions also can come in our mind, that why cow has four legs, we have only two legs? Why the birds can fly, others cannot fly? And etc, etc, etc. There was a Greek philosopher whose name was Aristotle. And in his book, Gate of Animals, gate means, we already learned about it, that gate means the movement, forward movement is known as gate. So that, in that book, Gate of the Animals, Aristotle asked himself so many questions and tried to find the answers, that why do different animals have the body part that they do have, and how do these body parts help animal to move, etc. What are the similarities in the body of different animals, what are differences in them, and so many questions. So if you want to know about more animals, movement of the more animals, you can get this book maybe from the library, or you can get from the website also, The Gate of Animals by Aristotle. Then maybe you will find out, so that you can know about the more types of creatures, that how they are moving forward and why they have special types of body shape and etc. So that is the way. Here we are going to finish this chapter in today's session also, and it will be followed by PDF file with some question answers, and thus maybe some pictures also. So write down in your notebook, and if any questions, query, doubts, write down in your comment section. Thank you very much.